Day 27, December 21st. In prior years, Pastor Paul Wallerzak, one of our Indiana Pro Staff members, has done a Christmas special for us, and he's been really busy with some other projects this year, so I'm going to take a stab at this. I'm going to keep it simple. I'm just going to read the Christmas story from Luke. So this is the classic Christmas story. And if you remember the Peanuts Christmas special every year, Linus would walk up and read this. And it's been read over and over and over, but you just can't get enough of it. You know, we talk about the true meaning of Christmas, and you know, we sometimes forget that in all the hustle and bustle and all the presents and everything, that the true meaning of Christmas is the fact that God sent His Son on earth to die for us, to be a Savior for all mankind. We somehow think that Santa Claus, that we're celebrating Santa Claus's birthday. So let's go through this real quick, and then I'm going to talk about today's hunt. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for a baby to be born, and she gave birth to the firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for him. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom His favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God in all the things that they had heard and seen, which was just as they had been told. It's pretty amazing, really, when you think about it, a story like that. If something like that happened, it would just knock your socks off. And yet we read this and we think it's some kind of a fairy tale or something, like this book is full of fairy tales. But this has been proven, the Bible has been proven over and over for its accuracy over the years. Many generations of people have tried to disprove the Bible and haven't been able to. So when you read this stuff really happened. I mean, this whole thing with the angels and the shepherds and the baby Jesus being born and placed in the manger, it's pretty crazy when you sit down and really think that it's not just a fairy tale that we talk about and read about at Christmas time, but this actually did happen. So don't forget that Christmas is not about the gifts. It's about the people. It's about the relationships that you have. It's about God sending His Son on earth to die for us. And just keep everything in its proper perspective. Well, I appreciate it, having a chance to talk to you about it, and I hope you have a great Merry Christmas. I'm not going to do another video blog, I don't believe, between now and Christmas. That's why I chose to go through the little Christmas message on today's video blog. But for the hunt, better get to that action. We're going to go on a pretty good little walk here, Zach and I, down to a spot that we haven't hunted all season. There's a little patch of big and beastie, and hopefully the deer haven't eaten it all yet. And there's a redneck blind right in the center of this little circle, semicircle of big and beastie. There's no telling what could come out there. We know there's a few mature bucks around that area, but like I said, we haven't hunted it this entire season anywhere near this spot. So it could be kind of fun just to go down, see what pops out. You know, I'm not going to be too choosy. I'll shoot any mature buck that comes out within reason, and we're gonna have a lot of fun. second. Yeah, it's a doe. Drake is gonna be getting that window open, yeah. I think as long as we don't move, she'll go back to feeding. Stuck it. Yeah, it's still good. Yeah, it smoked her. I was right, the heart wasn't out yet. I saw blood when she ran across that. I've got about 45 minutes left, and I shot a doe maybe about an hour ago, maybe a little bit more than that. That was pretty cool. We have not hunted this spot yet this entire season, and I've been trying to take a few does from various parts of the farm, you know, spreading out that, you know, the harvest of the does. We hadn't shot anything down here, of course, so I'd be more than happy to take one more if I could. Another small group of them came out, but they were acting real spooky. My guess is that they saw us walk in, and they came over here trying to figure out where we went, because they didn't have us pinned down in the blind, but they definitely weren't comfortable out here. One small buck so far, and that's been it. This is in the range of this buck that we had called the tight rack 10. And I haven't ran a camera here since October, but he was on there pretty consistently back in October. And I think he was living for the most part on this slope to our right. It's real thick and brushy up in there. That's where he was coming from in a lot of the pictures that we had of him back in October. So if he's still alive and still around, it wouldn't surprise me to see him pop out from the right sometime before this evening is over. We're in a little small bottom, separated from the big field that we a lot of times hunt. If you watch Midwest Whitetail much, you've probably seen us sitting in a redneck blind overlooking a great big bottom field. We changed it up a little bit this year because it's so hard to hunt that big bottom field with a bow. You can see a ton of deer, but they're almost always out of range. So we've got a little patch of big and beastie right on this end. A lot of it's been eaten already. I think the deer have just been pounding it this past month, but there's still some in there. The layout is a lot more bow-friendly in this corner of this little food plot than when we were hunting that great big 7-acre plot. This is probably going to be my last interview. The rest of it should hopefully be a lot more action and maybe another arrow flying at a doe here pretty quick.